Hello friends, my name is Likith and today our topic is rational numbers. Might be thinking what is rational numbers. So I'll just show you in a number line. So if this is a number line and middle 0, you know write the integers, so minus 1 and then minus 2, and you have your 1 and then you have your 2. Now in between over here you have 1/2. That's a fraction. And over here also, 1/2. This is 2/4. So this is 1/2. And now if you see this side, it's also 1/2, but it's negative. So this is a rational number. These are also rational numbers. And even minus 2/4. So also are rational numbers. So rational numbers are, you have like you have P and then you have Q. So P is any integer and Q is any integer that is equals to 0. And it can be negative or positive. Now, how to identify a rational number as negative or positive rational number? So, I'll give you two examples over here. The first example is -1/4 and 1/4. Now, in this, you can see you have the negative sign over here. So, if you have any one negative sign in denominator or in numerator, in any one, then it becomes a negative. And in this has both positive. So this is positive. So this how we understand. I'll show you another example. So in this example, 6/7, -6/7. And 7/16 and 8/16. Now you see in the numerator there's a negative sign, there's a negative number, so this will become negative. And this, it has the negative sign in the denominator, so this also is negative. And this has both positive. So it does not have any negative, so this is positive. Okay. Now I'm going to tell you how to compare. How to compare and order them. So how to compare is, now I'll give you two rational numbers. The first way to compare is, it's the simpler one. So if you get -6/7 and 8/16. So which one is greater? So you might know negative numbers are smaller than positive numbers. So obviously, which one is a positive rational number, which be the greatest one. Now, the thing comes, if both are positive, you can compare it very easily. Like you know, right, in fraction you learned you have to take the LCM of these two and then you have to convert and then you have to compare. So then you can do it. Like, let's solve this problem, 16 and 18, right? So 16, 18, so 2 edges are 16, 2 nines are 18. Then you take 2, 2 4s are 8, 9 goes like this, then 2, 2 2s are 4, 9, then 2, 2 1s are 2, then 3 3s are 9, then 3, then 1. So both are 1. So you have to multiply these all things. 2 1s are 2, 2s are 4, 4 1s are 4, 4 2s are 8, 8 1s are 8, 8 2s are 16. 16 ones are 16, 16 twos are 32, and then you have to be counting, and then 6 4s are 4, 6 3s are 48, and then 48 into 3. So you can do 48 into 3 at the side because it's a large number. 8 ones are 8, 8 to 16, 8 threes are 24. Now you have 4 4s, 4 4s, 4 threes 12, 13, 14. So answer is 144. So you have to convert these two in 144, and then you have to multiply the same number, and then you have to find out. So this is how you do it. Now, problem comes when both are negative. I mean, negative rational numbers like minus 6 by 7. I'm taking these examples, and minus 7 by 8. So first, for this also you'll do the same method like this. First you have to find the LCM of these two. So the LCM, these both are like, they do not have, like, okay, let's take another example for simple things. So, and then minus 1 by 2. Minus 1 by 2. Now, 7 and 2 are prime numbers. So, you can just multiply them for the LCM. 7 on 7, 7 to the 14. So, you have to convert minus 6 by 7 into, you have to make it 14, so you have to multiply by 2. So, 6 is 12 by 14. And now you see 1 by 2. 2 sevens are. So this equals to 7 by 14. Now you can compare. 12 by 14 and then 7 by 14. So which is greater? 6 by 7 is, minus 6 by 7 is greater. So the answer is minus 6 by 7 is greater than minus 1 by 2. So in this example, they both were prime numbers, so you could do that easily. But let us see what will happen if you do with different, like 7 by 16. Okay, like let's take 7 by 8, minus 7 by 8, and 8 by 9. So these two, they are not prime numbers. They're composite numbers. So let's take the LCM over here. So you know, right, what's LCM? Least common multiple. So you're finding a least common multiple between 8 and 9. So first we start with 2. 2 4s are 8, 9 stays there. Then again 2. 2 2s are 4, 9 stays there. Then 2. 2 1s are 2, 9 stays there. Then 3. 3 3s are 9, 3 stays there. Then 3. 1. So you have to multiply these all things. 3 1s are 3, 3 3s are 9. First we can do this. 2 1s are 2. Okay, 3 1s are 3, 3 6, 3 3s are 9. 9 1s are 9, 9 2s are 18. And then 18 2s are 36. 36 2s are, you can do it at the side over here. Now the answer for this is 72. So you have to convert this number to 72. So minus 7 into 8 into 9 gives 72. So we'll do the same thing. So 7 9s are, so 7 9s, and then 8 9s are 72. Now we do for 9. 8 by 9 minus 8 by 9. So 9 in which time it comes in the 9 table, like 9. So it comes in the 8. So 72, and then 8 8s are. So now it is easy to compare. 63 by 72 and then 64 by 72. So which one is greater? 64 by 72 is greater. So minus 8 by 9 is the number which is greater than minus 7 by 8. Now we'll find out how to do the ascending and descending process. Now for ascending and descending process, I'll just give you some numbers. Minus 6 by 7, minus 2 by 3, minus 5 by 6, and then minus 2 by 4. So you have to arrange these in ascending order. Let's see ascending and descending. So over here we'll write ascending and over here we'll write descending. So first you have to transform these all numbers into one similar denominator number. So for that we need to take the LCM. So like take the LCM in the side. So 7, 3, 6, 4. So first let's start with 2. So it will be 2 3s are 6, 2 2s are 4, 3 remains, 7 remains. And then you can take another 2. 7, 3, 3, 1. Now we can go with 3. 3. 7 remains, 1, 1, 1. And then 7, 1, 1, 1, 1. So you have to multiply these 3. 7, 1, 7, 7, 14, 7, 21. 21 into 2 is 42. 42 into 2 is 84. So you have to convert all these numbers into 84. So to convert them into 84, let's start over here. First let's do with minus 6 by 7. So if you want to convert it into 82, let's check it again. So it's 84, sorry, it's 84. So how to convert minus 6 by 7 into the number which has a denominator of 84? Let's just divide 84 and then 7. 7 1 is 7, 7 1 is 7, 7 2 is 14. So the answer is 12. So you have to multiply it by 12 to give it 84. So you have to multiply 12 over here also. So what will 6 multiplied by 12 give? So it's 82. 82 by 84. So let's check for minus 2 by 3. So let's do the same thing. 84 by 3. 3 ones are 3. 3 ones are 3. 3 to 6. 3 twos are 6. Then 3 1s are 3, 3 2 is 6, 3 3 is 9, 3 4s are 12, 3 5s are 15, 3 6s are 18, 3 7s are 21, 3 8s are 24. So the answer is 28. So you have to multiply it 28 times. That gives you 84. So 2 into 28 times, 8 1s are 16, 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4, 5 6. So the answer is 66 by 84. Now let's convert minus 5 by 6. So let's do the same division process. So over here, I'll put 84 and then 6. So 6 1 is 6. Then over here 6 1 is 6. 6 1 is 6. 6 2 is 12. 6 3 is 18. 6 4 is 24. So you have to multiply this 14 times. So you have to multiply this 14 times to get 84. So you have to multiply this also with 14 times to get the number. So 5 into 14. So just put 14 and then to 5. 20. Okay, answer is 70. So let's go with the last one. Minus 2 by 4. So again we'll divide. So this 84 and this is 4. So this might be very simple. 4 1s 4 2s are 8. 4 1s are 4. 21. So into 21 equals to 84. Now the same thing we have to do with 2 into 21. So let's try it. 21 into 2. 2 1s are 2. 2 2s are 4. So it's 42. So answer, we get all of them. Now with this we can compare which one is bigger and which one is smaller, right? So first, these all are negative, so you can go. If there is any positive, then no need to convert it. You have to put the positive for last because that will be the highest. But all are negative, so no need to do that. So let's go back to our question. So over here, first we need to do ascending order. So you have to find smaller to bigger. So in the numerators, the smallest is in minus 2 by 4. So I'll put minus 2 by 4 first over here. That's done. And second is minus 2 by 3. So I'll put that second. And third is minus 5 by 6. So I'll put it third. And then fourth is minus 6 by 7. So I'll put it fourth. So for descending, you can do this. So the largest is minus 6 by 7. And the second largest is minus 5 by 6. The third largest is minus 2 by 3. And the fourth largest is minus 2 by 4. So this is how you'll arrange them in ascending and descending order. And now, in case you get a number 3 by 4 and it's positive, positive rational number, then it's very easy. In ascending order, you put it at last. And in descending order, you put it at first. Because this is the highest and this is highest. So in descending, highest to low, so we put highest number first, so 3 by 4 first. In ascending, highest number last, so this will be last. Why this is highest? Because these all are negative and this is positive. You know, every time you can even check in this, all the positive numbers will be more than the negative numbers. So because of that, without doing any process, if we have a positive rational number, we can directly put it as the highest. But if you get another positive rational number, then you have to find the LCM of these two positive rational numbers and then you have to do it. Okay? So, thanks for watching this video.